We're only about half a mile past Braunston Junction. We're supposed to meet somebody here.
I know, and they're not here yet.
We might as well get a brew while we're waiting.
We'll wait.
Otis, put kettle on.
Well, it was lovely and sunny when you left us, and I don't know what you've done, but it's all cloudy and dank and cooler now. We've actually been here a couple of weeks. We took a couple of weeks off because it was nice. But we're back and we're off towards Rugby today. Hillmorton Locks we've got to go through, three locks. It's supposed to be the busiest in Britain. It has been lovely. It's a lovely spot. The internet's been good. On our right-hand side, you can see all this cattle grazing in the field. If you look closely at the field, you can see these like troughs, and they date back to medieval times. They're called ridge and furrows, and they were dug on purpose because the higher ridges were drier than the lower ones. So what you do is they used to grow crops that would do better in dry soil on the top, on the ridges, and then on the lower parts, on the furrows, it was always like a natural drainage, so they'd grow crops that did better in wet soil. And they'd give each strip to peasants back in the day, really from Roman times right up until the 17th century. But then the greedy landowners took over and started grazing cattle, and it's been like that ever since.
What?
Sound like Ian McKellen then?
No.
All right. Look at this for a mooring. We get a lot of questions about how we manage to get food and provisions, especially when we're out in the country like this, or if it's in the middle of winter. And it's quite easy because the supermarkets do home deliveries, but as long as you've got a postcode and address that they can find, they will come and deliver there to you, and you just take your trolley, pick the bags up and take it back to your boat, don't you?
Yeah.
In fact, some of the drivers will even bring it to the boat if they know whereabouts you are. Seen Shaun's thing on his chin?
It's an Otis injury.
Otis 1, Shaun 0. Again. That's Bridge 83. Back in the 1830s, there was a lot of work done to straighten out the Oxford Canal. I wonder if it'd work on you. the laugh means no. And here is one of the points where it actually used to go around the hill. And you can see, if you look backwards, there's like a cutting, you can see the trees. And there was a lot of these cuttings and aqueducts and things made to shorten the Oxford Canal, because there was so much traffic moving up and down that the boaters were wanting quicker journey times between there and where they were going.
Did
that make sense?
No. Yeah, it did.
First bit of noise we've had, innit? The M45 motorway just in front of us. And just behind us, you can see them doing some work just to the banks. It's getting to that season now, from November through till the end of March, where the Canal and River Trust do a lot of maintenance work across the system. And they shut a lot of parts of the canal down and like close towpaths, and they do tons of work replacing lock gates and resurfacing towpaths and building them back up, just things like that, ready for the next season. And we spoke about it a few vlogs ago, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
So they released these details so that you can plan ahead. It's always fun though, watching on social media when people don't read the notices and get trapped between two locks for 6 months. Hilarious for us.
Thank you.
Most of the old buildings next to almost any canal were once used for trade back in the days of the old working boats. Wharves, warehouses and stables lined the canals, and although most of them have been demolished or just fell into ruin over the years, a few of them have been tastefully redeveloped, some into private housing or some other uses. There's also plenty of pubs along the canal side. You can tell the old boaters like to drink. These are the famous Hillmorton Locks. We're going down them today. There's three of them. Well, actually, no, there's six. Three sets of two. When they first built the canal, there was just three single locks going down, or up, depending which way you're going. But it became a bit of a bottleneck, because it was really busy, especially during the early 1800s. So they built a duplicate single lock next to the original to cope with the traffic. Now, according to the Canal and River Trust, last year this was the busiest set of locks on the network. Over 9,000 boats came up here and down. But back in the 1840s and 50s, there was 20,000 boats a year coming up and down. Just imagine that. There's a team of friendly volunteers here at Hillmorton Locks, and they help boaters up and down the flight. They look after the gardens, which won an award last year, and they're always happy to pass on the knowledge and experience. When you're continuously cruising like we are, it's always really helpful to have people like this who know the local area, because they can pass on advice and tips that you don't really find in the books. The volunteer lock keepers have got their own website, and I'll leave a link in the video description if you want to check it out. This is not where we were.
No.
After we left the water... Well, no, not after we left the water point. After we were pushed off that water point.
Oh, yes.
That was mad, wasn't it? The weather turned a bit reachy.
Reachy?
Yeah, I've been reading Urban Dictionary. That's one of the cleaner ones I can say. It turned a bit reachy. In fact, it got a bit wet and windy.
Yeah.
So we had to battle on, because we've got to get past the stoppage just a bit further up north, otherwise we get trapped and then we can't film the new boat build this winter.
And we don't want that.
So we had to keep going, but because all our filming equipment basically comes off the pound shelf at B&M, we can't film in the wind and rain, otherwise the footage would look a bit like this. And we don't want that, do we? So we had to carry on. So we got to Rugby, we did a bit of shopping, yes. and we carried on and we carried on and we carried on, and then we couldn't find anywhere to moor. So we ended up on a completely different canal.
Yes.
Which is a bit random, isn't it?
It is a bit. I don't know which one we're on.
Yeah, can you guess which one we're on? Otis knows.
Otis knows, he's just telling us.
So about 500 yards that way is Hawkesbury Junction. And we came off the Oxford onto Hawkesbury Junction, and we did like a sharp kind of 180 in a way, isn't it?
It is, yes.
Onto the Coventry Canal.
Yay!
Hawkesbury Junction, which is just back there, it's like one of the most recognisable places on the canal system. I think nearly every narrowboater will know Hawkesbury Junction.
They should do if they've been here.
If you're like a masseur in Cockermouth, you've probably never heard of it, but you know what I mean? Everybody that's got a narrowboat will know it. Because there's some iconic places like the Greyhound Pub, which has been there donkey's years. Yep, there's that bridge, that ironworks bridge that goes over the junction. And then the old engine pump house, which used to pump water into the canal from a well.
A well?
A wishing well, I think.
Were there any money in it?
No, Terence Trent D'Arby wrote a song about it. Remember it?
Yes.
I think he's a Buddhist now.
I've no idea.
And there you go, you see. So we carried on up there, and we moored right on the edge of the visitor moorings. where it's nice and quiet.
It's been lovely.
Because there's some generators down there. The first place we stopped at, he had two generators, didn't he? Shaun looked at him and laughed. This poor bloke didn't know what was going on. So we set off and we moored up here.
Yeah.
But it's time to move on today. We've got to beat this stoppage and we haven't got long now, have we? So we're off towards Nuneaton. You can't say Nuneaton without saying Nunny, which is also good, isn't it? Are you all right this morning? You've been on your happy pills.
He's doing it to me again this morning, isn't he?
Otis is very quiet. I hope he's not taking his second poo on the boat.
No, he's just had one down there.
Oh, that's good. Right, you ready, Maud?
I am.
Off we go.
Come on, Gert. Gert.
Just before you get to Bridge 13, Bedworth Hill Bridge, on our port side, it's funny because everything's been on starboard side, hasn't it?
For ages. Is it?
Yeah, it has. On our port side is the Newdigate Arm, which, yeah, I was just attracted because it was called Newdigate. I'm going to be honest here. It went down to a railway which linked to a colliery, which was owned by Sir Edward Newdigate. And he was quite an entrepreneur. He owned and ran quite a lot of stuff back in the day around here. It's not navigable anymore, but you can still see the arm.
Just stop doing that.
Few people have told me to keep an eye out for Charity Dock, which is just down here. It used to be an old loading wharf for one of the collieries just to the west of us, but apparently it's now a boatyard with a bit of a eccentric reputation.
All right.
So get the camera out.
Ooh.
Kim and Aggie would have a right day in there.
They would, yeah. Half of these people don't even know who Kim and Aggie is.
We're at Bridge 15, which is where Marston Junction is. And if it had been his lucky day, today I would have been taking Shaun up the Ashby. You're laughing echoes when we go under a bridge. 22 miles of luck-free cruising and some lovely countryside up there as well, up the Ashby. But we're on a mission, we've got to get up north, so...
The Ashby's another time.
This time, it's farewell. Adios, au revoir, auf Wiedersehen. Smell you later. I was walking Otis on the towpath, and just as Shaun was approaching Bridge 17, I could see a boat coming from the other direction, and at some speed too. So I turned round and signalled to Shaun to stop the boat and wait for him to pass, because there was no way this guy was going to be able to slow down once he saw Shaun. I also shouted to the other boat to slow down, otherwise he'd hit us at the other side of the bridge, but he totally ignored me. You can see from the video that by this point, Shaun had already stopped the boat, and in fact he was going backwards, edging towards the bank. But this guy was just powering forward, aiming straight for the bow of our boat. Now watching this footage, you'd think that he's going to smash straight into us. And to be honest, it's a miracle that he didn't. We made it very clear to this guy that he needs to slow down, especially when he's approaching a bridge or a corner where you can't see what's coming the other way. We'll be right back. We're in Nuneaton.
Nuneaton.
Two people have told us not to moor in Nuneaton, and two people have said, it's all right in Nuneaton. We didn't have the best welcome, really, did we? A boater was coming through a bridge that was on a corner, a little bit fast.
Poof.
And he had to slow down rather quickly, and just missed us by that much. 6 inches. That is 6 inches. He missed us by 6 inches. But luckily, everything was all right.
It was.
No collision, no swearing, no shouting, and Shaun wasn't touching cloth, which is always a bonus. We've come indoors because we thought you might like a change of scenery.
Yeah, and it's nice in here.
So you can see all our junk in its glory. It's been a weird vlog as this one.
Junk.
Because what? Sorry. People might want to see my junk, I don't know. what? You've been all right in today, you are. We managed to squeeze like over 30 miles into one episode today. We started off just outside Braunston, where we had that very strange man steering for a while.
Oh yeah, I don't know who he was.
He turned back into you, so that was some really clever editing, wasn't it?
It was.
did the Hillmorton Locks, then it rained and rained and rained and rained, so we reappeared at Hawkesbury Junction, which was really nice, but we had a bit of a to-do because we had some coal. Well, we thought we had some coal stolen.
Yeah.
It's a little bit like that because I think it's six of one and half a dozen of the other, depending on whose version of events you believe.
Yeah.
We arranged, because it was quite cold and wet and windy, we arranged to have some coal delivered, and Matt and Ali from Boating Beyond Channel were with us. So we got an order together and the coal man delivered the coal, but it was too much to take to the boat. So we had the trolleys and we could take about three or four bags at a time. So we locked four of the bags in one of the safe areas at the CRT services, just for the few minutes it takes to get to the boat and back. Got back to the services and they'd gone.
It had all gone.
The four bags of coal had disappeared. Now, luckily, the Greyhound pub's got CCTV that overlooks the CRT services. So we very politely asked if we could look at their CCTV. And sure enough, the CRT staff turned up literally seconds after we'd gone with the trolley, opened the storage
and took the coal,
took the four bags of coal, threw it on their van and drove off with it. Now, we don't know why, we don't know the reasons why or why they wanted it or whatever. Apparently there's no issue with leaving it, we don't know, but we got in touch with CRT and the coal was returned to us.
It was
within minutes. But they didn't say anything, they just kind of dropped it and left it and didn't say hello or goodbye or anything. So I don't know what was going on. It's a bit of a Scooby-Doo mystery, I think, isn't it, that one?
Scooby-Doo?
It's a bit of a Scooby-Doo mystery. It's always the caretaker, though, of Scooby-Doo, isn't it?
Yeah, it always is, yeah.
We left Hawkesbury and we went through Nuneaton. And we're just on the outskirts of Nuneaton, on the north side. We've just stopped at Springwood Haven Marina to get some fuel and some water. And we've just found a lovely little spot about 300 or 400 yards further on from there, and we're going to stay here for a couple of days. We've got some decisions to make though next time. We're coming up towards Faisley Junction.
Which way do we turn?
We could go down into Birmingham. We like Birmingham.
I love Birmingham.
We like Birmingham. Or we could continue north. I think you know where we're going. We've kind of said over the last 10 vlogs that we're going back north, haven't we? But that's it for today. We hope you've enjoyed your little journey with us. If you have and you're not already, please subscribe to the channel. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. If not, don't worry about it. That's fine as well. Just buy a Mars bar and do whatever you wish to do with it. You can hit the notifications bell, which was a bit ago, and YouTube will let you know every time we release a new vlog. Even better, if you'd like to support the channel and support our journey, you can do so on Patreon. There is a link up above Shaun's head.
Just there.
Or there's a join button if you'd rather do it through YouTube. Just go to the join button on any of our pages.
I think we're done, aren't we?
I can't believe how far we are from London. We must be like 100 miles or more from London now.
Oh, lots more.
We'll see you next week. Take care of yourself. Bye.
Ta-ra.
we're going to get hit by this oak tree.
5, 6, 7, 8.
And take the trolley. And I still can't get it right. It's so simple. Why can't I do this? The big supermarkets, ping! And we're out in the middle of the nowhere. In the middle of the nowhere. This is a long take. How long has this been going on? 16 minutes we've been trying to do this. He's a naughty fox. In fact, some of the drivers will even bring it to the boat if they know whereabouts you are. Hey!
Short and sweet.
Bit like you.
No!
Don't look at the camera.
Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Mercy. Mercy.
Bless his cotton socks. We need some socks and some shopping. Trod on the dog or you
can't say that.
If it had have been his look.
Didn't know that poked out.
Ones that look like plums.
That looks wonky, that.
No, it's fine. I don't know how to please you. That was quite polished.
It was.
I think I polished that off very well. Until next week, take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.
Ta-ra.